earliest software engineers were women. And it only became male-dominated when I think people realized how much power software engineers had, how important and complex that role was. And so increasingly, as more men entered the industry, there were all kinds of gatekeeping tactics that happened. I think another part of, I wouldn't say a huge role, but it definitely played a role, was the introduction of personal computers. They were marketed to men. They were marketed in particular to boys, right? Because you could play games on these computers. So a big part of the marketing was to get boys interested in computers so they would play games. And that sort of just alienated the girls. So starting around the mid 1980s, actually, you saw the percentage of women in computer science programs go down, whereas the percentage of women in all the other, in almost all the other fields, like law, medicine, other sciences, etc., those actually kept going up. So starting from that 1980s, we really saw a big decline in the number of women going into computer science. Our world, our future, is dominated by technology. And that technology is typically just created by men. And so, you know, a lot of times we don't know what we're missing if we don't have all the voices in the room, right? And I wanna think about the possibilities that could arise if we get more diversity, making these decisions, figuring out, you know, how we can use tech to enrich our lives rather than control our lives. And I would like women to be more a larger part of that discussion. I don't think, you know, all women need to be software engineers in order to be part of that discussion. But I think simple confidence in their abilities, computer literacy, the ability to speak up, that's, I think, really important. We do several things. So one is visibility. Creating that visibility for the people who are already in the industry who are women and trying to give them a voice. We also do specific, I think, individual reach outs. And that, I think, comes from making sure our marketing is more representative. So making sure that on our website, we also have pictures of women, because we find that with just these small improvements, they can really give girls and other women a little bit more confidence to do stuff. Another thing that we do, and we've done in the past, we've done scholarships for single moms, for women, and then also for other minorities like LGBTQ. And I think just having these scholarships there really motivate people to come out from, you know, come out from the woodwork and apply for our program. What it needs to be is a consistent effort. So a consistent effort to have events that target women, make sure that our panels are well represented, make sure that our website and our marketing materials have women, make sure that we're doing reach out and engagement with the community. All of that has to be a consistent effort. And even with the consistency that we've had, it hasn't been an upward trajectory. And I think people can kind of be a little frustrated or disappointed when they see that. But for us, we're looking at the bigger picture, right? Things will go up, things will go down, but we are seeing an upward trend, and that makes a huge difference. I think one thing that we should get rid of is the boys and girls sections in the toy stores, because oftentimes you'll see that in the boys section, they'll have toys that are more about careers and career building, right? So you'll see like the construction sets or like the cool puzzles and things like that there. And in the girls section, it's usually dolls, dress up, things like that. And I feel like, you know, that's not just bad for girls, but it's also bad for boys, right? Because I think it teaches boys that they can only be one thing, and it teaches girls that they can only be one thing. Also, being really aware of the packaging that we have, who is on the packaging, what are the colors, how is it marketed? Kids are just so perceptive. They pick up on the smallest things, and I think we have to be aware of that and acknowledge that And also think about how that might affect them as they grow up.